Hi, I'm Liz from ARCA Space, and on this week's episode, we'll be showing you some of our test preparations, as well as answering some of your most frequently asked questions.
Checking out the Space Mural Museum today down the street from ARCA. As you can see, we're checking out some of the old rockets and we are looking at some of the old NASA stuff that's here, and we're just basically here to get inspired as we progress towards the Demonstrator 3 launch. And come check it out. It's just outside of Las Cruces. They got a cool little gift shop, and we're just basically here to take a trip down and just check out some of the cool stuff they have here.
Demonstrator 3 Aerospike engine and the Haas 2C8 test tank. This is a configuration for the test article, which will be integrated onto the test stand next week. The capacity of this tank is the same as that of the Demonstrator 3 and will allow for our engine ground test to be at the same duration as during flight.
Hello, here we are answering one of your most frequently asked questions. I'm a little bit amused because my colleagues were asking me to answer these questions without seeing them in advance of this video recording. So let's see how good I'm able to handle everything. So. Honestly, I read this first question before, so I know the answer to it. The question is, has the engine been tested yet? When will it be? No, the engine was not tested yet. We are going to integrate the test article on the test stand next week, and we hope to be able to start the engine test in maximum 2 weeks from now. And from now on, we have only questions that I was not able to read them before. Livestream public viewing, yes. We intend to have live streaming from the launch of Demonstrator 3 rocket from Spaceport America. And we are going to have a spectators area where the public will be able to, from where the public will be able to see the launch. What is the engine made out of? How is it constructed? It is made of composites. We have two different layers of composites. An internal layer that is able to withstand 250 degrees Celsius temperature from inside, and an external layer that is a mechanical layer. And the temperature of the mechanical layer is not going to reach more than 150 degrees. The mechanical layer is made of fiberglass and epoxy resin, while the thermal layer is made of composites also, but we can't tell you exactly what the material is used for that.
How does the engine steer? Why the fins?
The engine is not going to steer. It's a ballistic rocket, that's why we have the fins that will allow the rocket to be aerodynamically stabilized. We are going to have a launch tower, and the rocket is accelerating on the launch tower until it reaches the minimum velocity for stable flight. This velocity in case of the Demonstrator 3 rocket is in the range of 14 meters per second, and at the end of the launch tower the rocket will have enough speed to allow the wings to offer aerodynamic stability. So the engine is not doesn't have any thrust vectoring or gimballing system to control the attitude or trajectory of the rocket.
What propellant aren't there more efficient ones?
For the Demonstrator 3 rocket, we are going to use hydrogen peroxide 70%, which offers an impulse at sea level of around 95 seconds and in vacuum of 126 seconds. Yes, of course, there are more efficient propellants. For instance, only mixing hydrogen peroxide with kerosene will offer a higher impulse for the same chamber pressure. But the purpose of the Demonstrator 3 flight is to test the Aerospike engine, to see how the Aerospike engine perform during flight from sea level all the way to space. It's relevant for us to use just hydrogen peroxide for this first qualification flight.
Why linear instead of toroidal? This question is referring to the Aerospike engine. We are using the linear engine for the Demonstrator 3 flight because we are also using a linear Aerospike for the HAAS-2CA rocket. We choose the linear Aerospike for the HAAS-2CA rocket because it allows us to control the attitude and trajectory of the rocket on all axes using thrust vectoring control. As I said during the previous question, we are not using any means of engine control, thrust vectoring or gimballing system for the Demonstrator 3 rocket, but we are using for the Demonstrator 3 rocket a linear aerospike because it's relevant for the HAAS-2CA rocket.
So, haven't other aerospikes been flown already?
Yes, they were. There were actually two programs, one in California and one performed by NASA, and they were testing toroidal aerospike engine, but the altitude achieved during this flight test was in the range of a few thousand meters, maybe even less than that. So Demonstrator 3 rocket is going to flight test the first linear aerospike ever, and we are going to fly in space the aerospike, which makes this the first space flight of aerospike engine.
How soon is the launch? What date?
We hope to be able to launch at the end of August. We are going to start the ground test at the beginning of August at the same location as the one for the launch at Spaceport America, and immediately after that we just need to integrate the engine in the rocket and perform the flight. So we hope for the end of August.
How much does the engine cost to build?
This is an information that we can't tell you. It's part of the business, but for sure we are going to tell you how much is going to cost the engine for the HAAS-2CA rocket once this will become commercially available.
What makes this better than other engines?
Like in the case of any engine, there are pros and cons. But what makes the Aerospike unique is the fact that it is able to perform altitude compensation. In the case of a classic engine with a conical or bell-shaped nozzle, these engines are adapted to perform for optimum performance only at one altitude. For instance, in the case of the first stage, the engines are able to perform optimum only at sea level, while in vacuum there are performance losses.
In the case of a vacuum engine, it performs well in vacuum, while at sea level has a very poor performance. And in a lot of the cases, these engines are not even able to work because the jet stream is detached from the nozzle walls, and there are a lot of vibrations, and it can result even in the destruction of the engine. In the case of the Aerospike engine, it offers optimum performance from sea level all the way to space. So it's definitely an advantage. So it's like taking a classic engine, and this will perform optimum at all flight levels. So that's it for the Q&A. I hope I did pretty well, and I was able to answer to your questions. And yeah, we are waiting for you to ask more questions, and we will be more than happy to answer in the future.